I never had any family history of stroke whatsoever. It just kind of came out of the blue. There was a few things before I picked her up that were starting to not really make sense. I'm right-handed, so when I went to the fridge to get some water, I used my left hand, poured with my left hand, and drank water with my left hand. I was thinking, this is weird. Why am I doing this? And when I drove her to the pharmacy, my hand started tingling a little bit, and my foot started tingling a little bit, and drove her back home. And then I realized that my hand was kind of dropping, and I started dragging my foot. That's when I knew something was up. She took me to a Mediclinic across the street, and I said, I'm not a patient here, but I think I'm having a stroke. The nurse took my blood pressure, and it was amazingly high. It was 238 over 188. And when the ambulance came, two paramedics took me in and took me to Foothills. I had a CT scan and MRI. They took me back to emergency. First thing I thought of was, oh, geez, I should phone my family to let them know that I'm okay. So I went to get my clothes out of the bag that they had there, and I just hit the floor, I just dropped. And they said, okay, you've had a stroke, we got the images back, and it's a clot in the left hemisphere of my brain. And so it impacted the right side of my body.
Around the world, we see about 15 million new strokes a year. And acute stroke treatments, like what's called endovascular therapy or clot removal, or using clot-busting drugs, helps about 10 to 20% of patients because they get to the hospital in time. But that still leaves 80 to 85% of the world's population who ends up needing rehabilitation for recovery.
I was in the hospital for 3 months. It was intensive because I could not feel anything on the right side of my body from the neck down. And it was like being stuck in quicksand. There was a time I couldn't even move a finger. Couldn't move my leg. I was numb, I couldn't feel anything. So every day would be physiotherapy, occupational therapy. I went to speech therapy for assessments at the start. I self-corrected after about a week and continued for the next 10 weeks.
In rehabilitation, what we're doing is trying to get the brain to rewire itself through a mechanism called neuroplasticity. And so there may be an area of the brain that's really dead, it's not working, and you're depending on some sort of experience, so working, doing repetitions of a movement, to get the brain to wire around that area of the brain that's died off.
When they were explaining what happened to my brain, the analogy they gave me was, if you work downtown and you drive downtown every day, and you drive down McLeod Trail, and there's an accident on McLeod Trail, now you can't take that route downtown, but we can show you how to get to work. There's other roads to get downtown. The therapists are like the Google Maps and the GPS for you. They'll say, okay, your tank's low, gas up here, this construction there, turn around. I remember they're teaching me how to stand from sit to stand, and I couldn't. I felt like I was gonna drop off a 10-story building and hit my head. You learn to follow their instructions and follow their lead. Nothing bad happens to you.
We have several different projects going on right now, and we're doing that across Canada as part of something called CanStroke Recovery Trials Network that I lead. One of them is looking at recovery of gait through the use of a split belt treadmill. And in that, we have people walking and we can control the speed of legs at different speeds to try to make them have a symmetric gait so they don't look like they limp as much as they might. And we're trialing a drug that may actually make a difference and it can improve motor recovery. We have other trials going on using upper extremity robotics that use the robot to try to help improve the upper extremity and to provide assessments of how people move and what their sensation and cognition is like after they have a stroke.
Yeah, I'm like night and day. Right now, like my right side of my right hand, I still can't feel the difference between a push or a poke, soft and rough. I can't tell if it's hot and cold or wet and cold. It's interesting, just your world becomes a lot smaller after a stroke. I have to really edit your life and decide on what's important and what isn't based on your energy levels and what you can do and what you can't do. And they teach you here on how to manage your energy, which is really important because with a stroke, your progress is not linear at all. It's not like training for a 5K or a 10K. You could one day be excellent and be able to move your fingers, and then 3 days later, for the next week, you can't do anything. It's very frustrating. I don't think there'll ever be a new normal, but just the tools they give you, it allows you to overcome all those obstacles every day.